My dear students, today we are going to deal with the next topic, which is equipotential surface. Now the question is, what is equipotential surface? From its word itself, we can say equal potential surface. So you can understand it easily that a surface at which every point has equal potential, same potential, so that is termed as equipotential surface. Now let us understand this. You can see these yellow lines are uniform electric field lines. And now three surfaces, you can see this V1, V2 and V3. These three are equipotential surfaces. It means if I consider any point over here, suppose P1 or here as P2, so the potential of point P1 will be equal to potential of point P2. So this is equipotential surface. Same way over here, if we consider suppose S point and R point on the surface V2, so that is again equipotential surface. Potential at point S will be equal to potential at point R. The same way, if I consider this next surface over here, let there are two points N and M. Again, potential at point N and potential at point M is same. So that is considered as equipotential surface. So that was the first example. Now, second example, we will take for a positive charge. Suppose a positive charge is there, Q greater than 0. You all know the electric field lines will be away from the positive charge. As you can see the yellow lines, these are showing the electric field lines due to a positive charge. And see, these are the concentric shells. So from the formula, we know potential is what? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R for a given surface. Suppose we talk about this first surface. This is first surface. So the radius of this surface will be same. So potential at point P, Q, R, S is going to be same. So this whole shell is considered as equipotential surface. So here we start with the properties of equipotential surfaces. Now, according to this property, work done to move a charge from point A to B along an equipotential surface, that is 0, WAB equals to 0. And it is very much clear from the definition of potential difference. The potential difference between two points B and E is given by VB minus VA, which is equivalent to work done A to B divided by Q naught. So if the potential of point A and potential of point B, that is same, you can see over here, because it is equipotential surface. So this potential difference will be zero. Hence we will get work done to move charge from A to B, zero. So that was the property. Again, I will conclude that the amount of work done to move a charge from point A to point B along an equipotential surface is zero. Next property is that electric field lines, they are always perpendicular to an equipotential surface. Let me give an example. Suppose if we deal with a point charge or uniform electric field lines. These are uniform electric field lines. If I draw an equipotential surface, this will be an equipotential surface that we have seen in previous slide. So over here you can see the electric field lines are perpendicular to the equipotential surface theta, the angle between electric field lines and the potential equipotential surface is 90 degree. How can we prove that? See, the work done to move a charge from point A to B, we can write integration from A to B E dot dl. As we know, work done to move a charge along equipotential surface is 0. So it means E dl cos theta will be 0. Now, as we know, electric field intensity and displacement cannot be 0. So it is possible if and only if when the cos theta is 0, and that is possible when theta is 90 degree. So here we conclude that electric field lines are always perpendicular to the equipotential surface. So my dear students, now we are going to deal with the third property of equipotential surface. Now what is that third property of equipotential surface? Suppose these are electric field lines. And now over here, if we consider two points, one point this as point P and second point as Q. So electric field intensity at point P will be more than electric field intensity at point Q. Now we will understand this with the help of this formula. See, electric field intensity is written as minus dV by dr, which is termed as potential gradient. This term E equals to minus dV by dr, that gives us potential gradient. So negative of potential gradient is electric field intensity. Now you can see here this electric field intensity is inversely proportional to dr. Dr is what? Dr is the distance between the two field lines here, dr. So less is the distance between two electric field lines, more will be the electric field intensity. So that was the next property, that electric field intensity is inversely proportional to distance between the electric field lines, or vice versa. Now next property, two equipotential surfaces, they can never intersect each other. Why? If suppose two equipotential surfaces, they intersect at these two points, so it means potential of this point or potential of first surface is equal to potential of second surface. So these two values are different and they must be same at the point of intersection, so which is practically impossible. So that's why two equipotential surfaces, they will never intersect each other. Now my dear students, we are going to deal with the electrostatic potential energy. Now how we'll define the electrostatic potential energy? Suppose there is a point O, origin, and we want to bring a charge Q1 from infinite to a certain point Q at one point. So when we are bringing this Q1 over here at the one point, the amount of work done will be 0 because no any other charge is present to oppose Q1. Now suppose another charge Q2 is brought from infinity to a certain point 2. Then again work done is suppose W2. So in this case, now this charge Q1, which is already there, there will be repulsion between this Q2 and Q1. So we have to do work to overcome this repulsion. that is stored as its potential energy. So work done in moving a charge from infinity to a point in the field against the electrostatic force, that is known as electrostatic potential energy. And mathematically, that W we can write as Q into V. Q, the charge, and V, potential due to another charge. Now let's take an example. Suppose two charges are there at certain distance R. So they are forming a pair of charges. So potential energy mathematically is written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon distance between the charges. So that is potential energy between 1 and 2. Now instead of direct distance between 1 and 2, if the position vectors of Q1 and Q2 is given to you as R1 and R2, as you can see, so the potential energy between these two charges, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon mod of R2 minus R1. Mod of R2 minus R1, that is the distance between point A and point B. So I hope you all are clear about this potential energy. Now my dear students, instead of two charges, suppose there are three charges like Q1, Q2 and Q3, and these are kept on the vertices of a triangle A, B and C. So if you want to calculate the potential energy, so there will be three pairs. The first pair will be of Q1, Q2, second pair will be of Q1 and Q3, and third pair will be of Q2 and Q3. So potential energy U, that will be between 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 1. So all over in simple formula, you can write it is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. For the 1 and 2, we will write Q1, Q2 upon R12. For 2, 3, Q2, Q3 upon R23. And for 3, 1, Q1, Q3 upon R13. So that is the potential energy. Now the same concept we can understand with the help of the position vectors. You can see three charges are there. The first charge you can see is at R1 position vector. Second charge Q2 at R2 position vector. Third charge Q3 at R3 position vector. So they are forming three pairs, Q1, Q2, Q2, Q3 and Q3, Q1. So the potential energy will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. As you can see, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2 upon R12, Q1, Q3 upon R31 or R13, same, and then Q2, Q3 upon R32. So this was a system of three charges. It was a system of three charges. So it is easy to find the potential energy of the system. If n number of charged particles are there, then potential energy can be written as by this expression. Always use this simple formula for the potential energy. U equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R12. So it will help you a lot to find the potential energy of system of charges. Now my dear students, we are going to deal with a very important topic, which is behavior of conductors in electrostatic field. Remember that this question was asked in board examination in 5 marks. That is very, very important. And most of the properties we have discussed in the previous lectures. The first one is electric field intensity inside the conductor, interior of the conductor is zero. You can consider, see, this is suppose a conductor. Now, if we talk about the electric field intensity inside the conductor, that is zero. So electric field intensity inside the conductor is zero. That is the first property of a conductor. Remember that this electric field intensity is independent from the shape of the conductor. Whatever the shape of conductor is there, electric field intensity inside the conductor is always zero. It is also termed as electrostatic shielding. Now the second property. The second property is again the electric field lines. These are always perpendicular to the surface of a conductor. Electric field intensity or electric field lines, these are always perpendicular to the surface of a conductor. Suppose if we talk about this conductor over here, if I want to draw the field lines, these field lines will make 90 degree from the surface. Suppose somewhere here, if the field lines are there, these field lines will form 90 degree angle. Anywhere, if we draw the field lines, these field lines will make angle 90 degree from the surface of conductor. That was the second property. Now the third most important property is that net charge in the interior of a conductor is always zero. Let me explain you this with the help of an example. Suppose this was a conductor. When this conductor is placed in uniform electric field, this is uniform electric field in which the conductor is placed. Now over here, when the conductor is placed in uniform electric field, the electrons which are present in this part, they will accumulate to the opposite direction of the field. As we know, force on the electrons will be minus E into E. The direction of force will be opposite to the direction of electric field. So all the electrons will accumulate to the left side, and the right side from where the electrons are coming, that will become positively charged. So all over, if you see, the resultant electric field inside the conductor is opposite to the outside the conductor. So hence we can say the total charge inside the conductor is zero. So that was the property, net charge in the interior of a conductor is zero. Next property, the charge always resides on the surface of a conductor. If you remember, in my previous lecture, I have explained this concept. Suppose there is a conductor. This is the conductor. And when the positive charge is given to this conductor, what happens? It will produce electric field lines away from the positive charge. So now, if the field lines are away from the positive charge, the electrons which are present on the surface over here, these electrons which are valence electrons, these electrons will move towards the center and they will neutralize this charge, and all the charge will appear on the outer surface of the conductor. So hence we can see whatever extra excess charge is given to a conductor, that is residing only on its outer surface. So I think it is clear to all of you, charges always resides on the surface of a conductor. And next property, electric potential is constant for the entire conductor. Now, next property, that electric potential is constant for the entire conductor. Remember that if we talk about any conductor, whatever the shape of the conductor is there, that will be equipotential surface. So suppose if I consider two points P and Q on the surface, the potential at point P and the potential of point Q, that is same. So it is equipotential surface. So amount of work done to move any charge from P to Q or Q to P will be zero. So if it is zero, it means E dot dr, or E equals to minus dv by dr. Here, if we consider, so potential difference, this dv is zero. So if electric field is zero, then electric potential will be constant. That is the basic concept. Again, I will explain this part inside the conductor. The electric field intensity is zero, which is equal to minus dv by dr. If the differentiation of a quantity is zero, it means that quantity is constant. I think this topic is clear to all of you now. So the last property, that is, whatever charge is given to a conductor, suppose conductor is not having a uniform shape and charge is given to this. So its charge density will not be uniform throughout the conductor. As we know, the surface charge density is charge per unit area. Okay, it may be 4 pi r square, pi r square, 2 pi r l, depending on the shape of the conductor. So sigma is inversely proportional to r square. So hence we can say the r, radius of curvature, is different from this conductor from surface to surface. So surface charge density cannot be uniform. So the first section of the chapter number 2, electric potential and potential energy, is done. Now my dear students, we are going to deal with the second part of this chapter, which is electrical capacitance. What is the meaning of this word capacitance? Let me explain you with one example. Suppose there is a conductor. We can give certain charge Q to this conductor. Suppose this Q charge, positive charge, is given to a conductor. So when the positive charge Q is given to this conductor, it holds that charge, that is the capacity to hold the charge. And that is electrical capacitance. Now if suppose the potential developed on this conductor is V, and that will be because of this charge Q. So we can conclude that this electric potential is directly proportional to charge given to the conductor, Q proportional to V. So when we remove the proportional sign, what we get? C, a constant, Q equals to CV. So this C constant is known as electrical capacitance. So formula of electrical capacitance is what? Q by V, charge given to conductor, divided by potential developed. So I think it is clear to all of you what is electric capacitance. It is capacity to hold the charge by a conductor, and mathematically the capacitance is given by charge divided by potential difference. Now if we talk about its unit, either you can write coulomb per volt, or else you can write farad. Remember that farad, not faraday. The unit farad is very, very large. So instead of farad, we can use microfarad, we can use picofarad, and so on. Now the symbol of capacitance, you can see, all of you, the capacitance is shown by two parallel lines. Okay, these two parallel lines.